Hello friends, welcome to Dreamweaver Crocheting with Love. In today's tutorial, I am going to teach you a stitch called puff stitch. A puff stitch is also referred to as a bead stitch. It is a 3D kind of stitch. Moreover, it is also reversible, which means that in this sample piece, as you can see, the stitch looks one and the same from both the sides. That's why it's also called as a reversible stitch. It's a very easy stitch and it's cute as well as adds a grace to your crochet work. So let's see how the stitches work. Moreover, at the end of this video, I'll show you few of my crochet patterns which I have done using this stitch. So let's begin. Now I already made the first row of double crochets. In order to work a puff stitch, I shall chain 3 and turn my work. Into the next stitch, I am working a double crochet. In order to work a puff stitch, I will skip the next double crochet and work 2 puffs into the single stitch separated by a chain 1 space. So let's see how this is done. In order to work a puff, I will first initially yarn over, insert my hook into the double crochet and pull a loop. So I have to hold it like this. So these two makes 2 loops for the puff. Now I am making a puff with 6 loops. So again I am going to yarn over, insert my hook into the stitch, same stitch, again pull a loop. Now I have 4 loops on my hook. For the third time, again I will yarn over, insert my hook into the stitch, pull a loop. Now I have 6 loops on my hook. So as I had said before, I am going to make a puff of 6 loops. So I shall yarn over and pull through all the 6 loops. Now I have 2 loops on my hook. Again I need to yarn over and pull through 2 loops. So my first puff is done. Now I am providing a chain 1 spacing between the puffs. So I will be working one more puff into the same stitch. Yarn over, insert the hook into the same stitch, pull a loop. Again yarn over, insert the hook into the same stitch, pull a loop. So this I have done for 2 times. For the third time, I am inserting my hook and I have pulled a loop. So I am having 6 loops on my hook. Yarn over, pull through all the 6 loops. Again I am having 2 loops on my hook. Yarn over, pull through the 2 loops. So I have made 2 puffs into a single stitch. Now I will be skipping the next stitch and working around 3 double crochets into next 3 stitches. This is the spacing that I am providing just for pattern. So in order to work my second puff stitch, I will be skipping the next double crochet and working a puff separated by a chain 1 space. Yarn over, insert the hook into the, again yarn over, insert the hook into and pull a loop. I am having 6 loops on my hook. I pull through all the 6 loops. Again having 2 loops on my hook, I am pulling through both the loops. So chain 1, that is the spacing that I had provided initially. Again please watch out carefully, it's a very easy stitch. You have to just yarn over, insert, pull a loop. Again yarn over, insert, pull a loop, yarn over, insert and pull a loop. So this is basically a puff which I am doing with 6 loops. If you want the puff to be more bigger, so you can work a puff with 8 loops, 10 loops. So whatever size you prefer, you can go for that. Again I'll skip the next stitch and work the last 2 double crochets to end this row. For the next row, I shall chain 3 and turn my work. Work a double crochet on top of the next double crochet. Now in this chain 1 space, that the spacing that I provided between the 2 puffs, I'll be making the puff stitch. So again I'm inserting into the chain one space, I've pulled a loop, again yarn over, insert, pull a loop, yarn over, insert and pull a loop. So 6 loops on my hook. I shall yarn over and pull through all the 6 loops. Again I have 2 loops, chain 1. So I think this stitch is very clear to you. It's a very easy stitch. Moreover, you need not make a puff stitch over a puff stitch. As I had mentioned earlier, and we have seen variety of stitch patterns like V stitch, fan stitches. So you can combine those stitches with the puff stitch and make different kind of crochet patterns and designs as per your choice or as per your creativity. So that's all up to you. But I think this puff stitch is quite clear to you by now. So I'll show you a few of my patterns which I worked using this puff stitch. Here, this is one of the bonnets that I have made using the puff stitch. Here, onto the top of a single stitch, I have made nearly 3 puffs. So you can do something like this. Also, there is a hat in which I have used this stitch along with the double crochets, which are the spacing between the puff stitches. So even this gives a very beautiful pattern. And in one of my baby bolero jackets, I've used this puff stitch as a corner so that it adds more grace to the crochet work. So in both the corners as well as on the back part, you can see I've made the corners using puff stitches. So I feel that this stitch is very cute and your crochet work will look attractive when you add these stitches to your baby patterns. So that's all for today's tutorial. I hope I was clear to you. If you have any queries, please let me know through comments. Thanks for watching and have a wonderful day.